Hello everybody, I'm Lonnie with Everything Nature, and today we are going to be talking about crinoids. Have you ever found something on the side of the road that looks kind of like this? What is it? Where do you think it came from? Well, it might look like a plant, but that is from an animal called a crinoid. Now, crinoids are part of the family Echinoderm, which also includes sea stars, sea urchins, sea cucumbers, and sand dollars. Now, when you look at a crinoid, it might look kind of like a flower or a plant, but it really is an animal, I promise. As you can see, the crinoid has three main body parts. It has arms, which are more like tentacles that it uses to catch its food. That's the kind of feathery looking parts at the top there. The head, or the calyx, that's where its mouth is. And then the stem is the long part that anchors it down to the sea floor. Millions of years ago, the central plains of the United States, all the way from the Gulf of Mexico through the Great Plains and into Canada, were under a very shallow part of the ocean. That's why in certain areas around here you can actually find pretty much predominantly sea creature fossils like crinoids, seashells, and ammonites, things like that. Now, usually when you find crinoid fossils, they're going to be in bits and pieces. Although it is possible to find a whole intact crinoid fossil, it's pretty rare. Now, where do you think is a really good place to find crinoid fossils? It's actually your driveway, but only if you have a gravel driveway. Most driveways and roads are paved with limestone gravel, and limestone is very often chock full of fossils. So the next time you're walking down a gravel road or even out in your own front yard, pay attention to your feet, and you might just find some cool fossils of some ancient sea creatures. If you love learning about cool nature-y things, please like this video and subscribe to Everything Nature. Thank you very much! My creme brulee is ready!